What's going on, workforce? Brian here, and today we're diving in more into the discussion of Phantasy Star Online 2 and obviously the exclusivity information that's coming out regarding PSO2 and Xbox and Windows 10. It seems that there is at least some thoughts and opinions, and I've got a couple comments here I want to highlight from my previous video, but there is the idea that Microsoft is basically the reason why this game is coming to North America. And there's still questions about Europe and Australia, and that's all still up in the air, and I'm assuming certain ink hasn't dried yet. Like, certain things haven't been signed, so there's nothing yet ready to to drop on us. But I do want to jump first into Zero Fight's comment here saying, Microsoft has foot the bill for the localization and has secured the publishing rights for PSO2 in North America for Xbox One and PC. So suffice to say the least, it is not releasing on PS4 for the West. Not a huge loss, as I think there are more people in North America playing on PC than on PS4 anyways, and so if Sony really cared for PSO fans in the West, then they would have localized this a long time ago, but they clearly don't. At least there will be full crossplay between Xbox and PC, which will increase the number of people playing it at all times, so server lobbies should be populated regardless. And Dakota follows this up and he says that they are using the Microsoft Azure to host the servers, and Microsoft is publishing it, so no doubt it will, so I doubt that it will come to other consoles. And so, like, I was not even aware of this, because even in the video I talk about, like, I hope that it comes to PS4 and Switch. Honestly, I still hope that is the case. Sony and Microsoft signed a huge deal regarding Azure. So I'd like to think that just because it's running in the Azure cloud, that doesn't mean that it's going to other places. Now, also, we see Microsoft, and whether they're studio acquisitions or with the Minecraft, they have a tendency to publish their games on other platforms. And being that this is a Sega game, maybe there is some kind of deal that's worked out. And so when it comes to exclusivity, personally, I'm always really against it. Like, as much as I know it's an impossible argument to make right now that I think even first party exclusives should go away, regardless of that, if you make the game, if you fund the game 100%, let's just let you keep it wherever you want. But I think really exclusivity in terms of third party really doesn't make any sense anymore, especially in the age of crossplay. I think ideally we can see and start to hopefully see a world where that doesn't happen. I want anybody on PS4 and Vita, like anybody in that ecosystem, to be able to play this game, especially if they're waiting. I wouldn't want them to go out and have to purchase an Xbox or a high-end PC. I don't know what the specs are on it. It's a 2012 game. I would think you could find a PC that could run it really well. But and if they're publishing it, I can understand. I don't like it, but I can understand the getting behind the idea of, a timed exclusive. And we see that happen a lot. A lot of the times that, especially during these conferences, fans of one or the other will always point out, like, oh, these are cross, third-party games. Yeah. Yeah, great. I want all games to be on all platforms. That's just where I fall. So we are obviously going to be going into the Nintendo event soon, and who knows what else they're going to have, because Phantasy Star, Online 2, it runs on PS4. And on Switch via the cloud in Japan. So it's not to say that it couldn't do that. So maybe, just maybe, things, are going to be a little bit different, especially because Microsoft's bringing Xbox Live to Nintendo Switch. There's a lot of these great relationships these developers and these publishers and these platform holders are doing and working together, and it's exciting to see that. And I think at the end of the day, like, we as gamers win. Am I excited for PSO2? Abso-freaking-lutely I am. I am disappointed that especially for those of you who are on PlayStation, and that's all you have, because that's all you can afford, because guess what? That's life for a lot of us, right? We can't always just have everything we want when we want it, and these, gaming as a hobby can be incredibly cheap, depending on, like, your strategy, but it can also be incredibly expensive if you're always, kind of the first to adopt, if you're always kind of day one, etc. So, that's frustrating. It is frustrating to hear this. I didn't catch that it was just going to be that. I was like, oh yeah, Windows and, Xbox. Okay, that's great. And then I'm assuming that we'll see some announcement later. And hopefully Microsoft doesn't lock this down. I think if they're publishing it, as the publisher, they get a cut anyway. Why wouldn't they want to cut on PlayStation? Why would they want to segment that market? Now, I think it's perfectly, like I said, reasonable if they want to have kind of the exclusivity deal over here for a time. I don't know what that time length would be. I'd be curious as to you think from a, like, if you were the publisher, how long do you think a time deal should last? For me, I think 6 months to a year. Anything over that is just a little bit mean. It's just not like come on, guys, let's have some fun. So I think this is, I mean, an excellent move by Microsoft to Zero Fight's point regarding if Sony really cared about it, they could have published it. They could have done the same deal probably a long time ago. I don't know what strings had to be pulled, but I'm really happy they were. And so those are my thoughts. I'd love to know yours. I'd love to know what you're thinking here, especially as it relates to timed exclusives, especially as it relates to, would you be picking this game up on PC if you don't like Xbox? Or, you know, is that the crossplay aspect excite you, etc.? Like, and then obviously there is a bunch of hardcore fans. My air just kicked on. There's just a bunch of hardcore fans that have already played the game. I think the patching and all that stuff got really annoying. So I'm really excited to kind of dive into this with a controller. And the fact that it is crossplay PC and Xbox to start, hopefully to start, we'll have to wait and see. I think right now, think of it as an exclusive. Don't sit here and, I guess, don't let me set the wrong expectation that I think that it's going to come. I hope that it will come. I think that's would be a smart move. I think it'd be a good move, a good gamer move. Good for the gamers, kind of, as Microsoft likes to say, you know, that they're in it for the gamers. So maybe they can prove it, you know, maybe they could prove that phrase. Anyway, like I said, love to know your thoughts on this, on anything we were talking about. And thanks so much for watching this video. If you're new here, welcome. we'll say, my name is Brian. This is Work to Game. I hope you have a fantastic day. I'll talk to you soon and take care. What's going on, Workforce? Brian here. And today we're kind of jumping into a little bit more Phantasy Star Online 2 thoughts and discussion, namely because we've got What's going on, Workforce? Brian here. What's going on? All right.